Okay, so other patterns are like adapter pattern or iterator pattern or the ES6 module pattern, right? So we already talked about the module pattern. Right, module pattern is actually used in core JavaScript to create a module, right? But now we are using the common JS modules and we are using the ES6 modules. I mean, that is called ES6 modules or ECMAScript modules. Or we might be using UMD or the AMD modules, right? In JavaScript, commonly like in the Node.js, we use a common JS modules where we do require like some library. This is how we require. And then while exporting that library or exporting a module from a file, what we do? Module.export equal to module name. This is how we do. And in the ES6, what we do? We use import export syntax, import React from this React library, right? And when we need to export, then there are different ways of exporting, right? Either you export simply export the class name directly, like export function. Just put this in front of the function. Export const string and all. So what you are saying in the, from this file that you are exporting constant x, and how you can require it, you just, if you need only x from that file, then we can just import, selective import x from whatever the file name is. Right, this is how we do it. And UMD modules use the required JS and where we asynchronously load the modules. Okay, so in this video I'm talking about so we already know module pattern, which is a core JavaScript. This is how we should actually create our own modules by binding everything inside a FE block, right? But in ES6, how we do it? Export const like greetings equal to hello world, right? Now this is just you declared in that file. So there are two kind of exports, default export or named export. Named export is when you have multiple things to export from a file. Like export function sum, and here I'm passing num one. Okay, here what you are doing. Right, so we export only. Some keyboard issue. So this is like if you have created these constants in the app.js file, consider it like this, okay? And you are writing another file which is a main.js. Okay. How you will import all these things? Import. Either what you need to do, import everything as alias, any variable name from, right? So how you can access them? Alias dot greetings, alias dot sum, all these like this. Otherwise, if what you can do selective import. You just want import x, import greetings only from this file. That's it, right? This is called named export, where you have multiple things to export from a file. But there can be a default export also where you have just a simple class name. Export class hello, right? And you put something blah blah inside it, right? Now what you can do, import blah blah from, this is correct. Because you are exporting only single entity from this file, so you can put anything here, blah, blah. So blah, blah will be representing this particular class. If you have a static method, like, so you can access it using blah, blah dot hello here. Something like this, okay. That's it about the ES6 module patterns.